Won't you sit down, Mr. Gogarty? By the way, I've hesitated to ask, but just who are you, Mr. Gogarty?
Mr. Gogarty is the wrong person to ask.
Who should I ask?
Why don't you ask Mrs. Gogarty?
Oh, I was so sorry to hear about your misfortune.
Mother, please.
If you want to get anything out of Mr. Gogarty, you'd better send for the district attorney.
You've probably all wondered who Mr. Gogarty might be.
Well, I admit I've been very curious.
Oh, yes. Just who are you, Mr. Gogarty?
I'll tell you all about Mr. Gogarty. At the moment, he's got me so upset, I don't quite know where to begin.
Well, if you don't know where to begin, I'm going to bed.
May I help you, Margot?
I'll handle this in my own way. Mother, I think you'd better sit down.
Oh? Who gets the smelly salt this time?
Just leave them here and stand by the phone for an emergency.
I've never seen so much excitement all my life. I declare there's something going on here every minute. I'm having such a good time, I hate to take my paycheck. Oh, don't mean that, because I got a little fur coat I better picked out. I'm going to wear it Thursday. You couldn't get me out of here with a pack of you.
Is somebody ill?
Not at the moment.
Why the smelling salts?
A good butler anticipates every emergency.
Everett, will you leave the room, please?
With pleasure.
Well, what I'm trying to say is that, well, during the excitement of war, we all made mistakes.
My mistake was making money.
Well, my mistake was Mr. Gogarty.
Darling, are you feeling all right?
Now, Mother, please, don't get excited.
What she's trying to say is that she is Mrs. Gogarty.
No.
Yes.
No!
It happened sometime during the war, didn't it, Mr. Gogarty?
No! Oh, it can't be! Oh, it can't be!
Mother,
no. No, no, no! Oh, no.
Now, Mother, please, you promised.
No.
Let me get this straight. Who is Mrs. Gogarty?
I won't be Mrs. Gogarty long.
You two are married?
Yes, sir.
Oh, how, when, where?
How could you do such a thing to me, your own mother? Mr. Gogarty, oh, it can't be.
Is there something wrong with me?
He's just being mean. He's trying to take advantage of the situation. Father, you've got to give me a divorce.
I can't get you one tonight.
Oh, what good are all those lawyers and people you've got around you?
Do you mind if I have something to say?
Yes, let Mr. Gogarty have something to say. I know he's going to cooperate.
Oh, I'm sure Mr. Gogarty will be a good fellow.
Naturally.
So you see, you're all getting hysterical over nothing. You'll get your divorce in due time.
Oh, I wouldn't be too sure about that.
Do you mean to say you're not going to give me a divorce?
I don't believe in divorce.
Now, you wouldn't want to hold a girl to a silly, impulsive war marriage, would you?
It wasn't silly and impulsive to me.
It was, too. It happened to a lot of my girlfriends, and they all got divorces without any trouble.
Oh, so you got married to me because everybody was doing it, and now you want to get a divorce because that's the fashion, huh?
You're being rather aggressive.
You know, I'd hate to start married life over again by throwing my wife into the swimming pool.
You're going too far.
And I'd hate to resume my peacetime activities by socking my wife's fiancé in the nose.
I might have something to say about that.
Skippy, she isn't engaged to you, too. Oh, Margot. Oh, how could you think your own
Stop
mother...
Stop moaning so we can make some sense out of this mess.
Why don't you try to act like a gentleman and go away?
Where would you have me go?
I wish you'd ask me that question.
I might do that sometime.
You don't intend to stay here.
Husband's place is by his wife's side.
Father, why don't you do something?
Serves you right.
I'm sorry to interrupt this dramatic episode, but what am I supposed to do about those newspaper people?
Well, what about them?
They're floundering around the pool in scanty attire, and one especially obnoxious character by the name of Schultz keeps yelling for more vodka.
Oh, we can't offend the newspaper people, Everett.
No, don't offend the newspapers, Everett. Stay here and offend me.
Oh, I can't stand anymore. This is too much. It's too much. It's too much.
It's been a pretty trying day for all of us. Where's our room?
Father! He's out of his mind.
Father!
Stop screaming and go to bed.